So in events, go to the index.html, go to event folders, click on event, inspect, go to console. So there is a button, there is a select box. You will see the code in main.js. Every index.html have at the bottom this JavaScript file has been included. So there is a button, on button there is an event, on click we are calling a JavaScript function, my function, and we are passing a variable event. Whenever we pass the variable event from like this here, so we go to the main.js. So whenever we pass the event object as it is, then we can write event.target.innerText. Target have many things under it which we will see now, but currently we are consoling the inner text. That means whenever this function is called from wherever, I think we can use the same functions also because the body is the same. So as you can see, we are using same function, we are triggering event from here and we are using that event object under event object target key, and we will have a number of keys, and we are using here inner text. So we will see in action here, like click me. So as you can see here, click me. If you want to debug the code, just go to the source main.js and click here, then refresh, then click me. That click me, the event object which you set from the HTML, this is the event object. Now event object in target you have this many things, you have value also, you have type also, but currently we are just consoling the inner text, which is click me. Click me is the inner text of this HTML part. Like here, if you change this, that will be reflected on the click me. Okay, same function is we are using for here also. This is a select type. So whenever you select or change, because we are using on change event, so this event occurs when you change the any options of select tag. So on that event, this function will called, this event will get captured and sent to as a parameter for this function, and that event object will have a target and inner text. Target means that event object will be the object of the instance or the function which is calling it. Suppose when this button called it, then this event captured. When this function, when this onChange event called, that means this onChange event has been captured for this function. So now whenever we change, it comes here and we get a inner text for second, third, that is the value of that options, and we got console here. So that much you can do the R&D with the different types of methods of the HTML and the JavaScript. We were just learning how to capture events. Thank you.